Good morning, Tritonians. I'm Jake.
And I'm Sam, and this is Viking TV.
So that's what VTV stands for.
We've got a packed episode for you today. Up first, Triton's Assisted Learning Center students got in the holiday spirit recently by creating one-of-a-kind ornaments and decorating a Christmas tree as part of the 2014 Festival of Trees.
The annual holiday fundraiser benefits two worthy organizations, the Anna Jakes Hospital and the Salisbury Beach Partnership.
2014 will mark the second annual Sea Festival of Trees, held at the Blue Ocean Music Hall, located on the ocean at Salisbury Beach. Businesses, individuals, student groups, and families from the surrounding communities showcase their decorating talents and establish a fun holiday tradition for families and the general public. What made us want to do this project is we wanted to be part of the community and kind of give back to the hospital and the Salisbury beaches. We have our white sand or our blue sand. You made a nice big yes. Do you want the white sand? Yeah, all right. So the theme of the Christmas tree is oceans. The kids got a chance to vote on the theme. So some of the ornaments that they made are starfish that you can see that we put some glitter and shells on. We also did some circular ornaments with sea glass and sand. All the students got to pick and choose what they wanted inside each ornament.
Yeah, you want that one?
All right,
can you
give me
a nice big push?
Thank you. Nice job. I know the kids are enjoying this project because they get really excited. As you can tell, Lexi's voice or someone smiling, or they really just appreciate what they're doing for the community.
What can Triton students learn about the spirit of Christmas from the project the students are involved in?
Triton students can learn by being thankful for what they have and giving back to the community, and that everyone can be a part of it.
All of us have smartphones in our pockets these days, but the phones are only as smart as the apps we download to them.
Those apps are used for a variety of things, from social media and gaming to more useful things like document storage and navigation.
Sure, it's true. I don't think I could find my way home without Google Maps.
Austin Mooney asked what apps you use the most in our second segment.
As hundreds of new apps are made each day, which ones can't you live without? We group the apps in four different categories: games, entertainment, productivity, and social networking. Then we ask some of you what your favorite apps are.
What is your favorite social media app?
I use Twitter the most.
Why do you use Twitter?
I use Twitter for advice, and I follow a lot of celebrities.
My favorite social media app is Twitter.
My favorite social media app is Instagram.
What's your favorite entertainment app?
I like YouTube.
My favorite entertainment app has to be Wattpad, because I like to read stories.
What app helps you the most with school?
The calculator app.
The app that helps me the most in school is Google Docs.
What's your favorite game on the App Store?
My favorite game on the App Store is Subway Surfer.
My name is Cam Weston. My favorite app is Clash of Clans. As you can see here, this is my base. Yeah, Town Hall Level 8. I'm all about my Clash. I'd like to give a shout out to my clan, Chicken Fry United. We got Cody Puckett right there. Some S-Dubes, Jake Ironballs. Alright.
According to the students we asked, Clash of Clans is the favorite game, YouTube is the favorite entertainment app, Twitter is the favorite social media app, and Google Docs is the app that helps you most in school.
Hey, have you tried Trivia Crack? I'm addicted.
One of the downsides to having an arcade on our phones is that we're tempted to fill every spare moment we have playing video games instead of talking to each other.
What? What? What'd you say?
Howie Livinggood explored some of the other pitfalls we run into when gaming consumes our lives.
Video games have become a favorite activity for most teenagers of this generation, but few people take into account the impact it can have on our educational and social lives. How do video games affect our lives?
What type of video games do you play?
I play action video games.
I play Halo, that kind of stuff, and GTA.
I play a lot of RPG adventure games, but along with a lot of Nintendo games, ones where you can really make decisions.
Mario Kart, sometimes Smash Bros.
has to do with Mario.
Pretty much.
About how long do you play video games each day?
Probably 90 minutes a day.
Maybe an hour.
I'm gonna say a solid 3 hours.
I don't play as often as I used to.
What do you think are some potential dangers of playing video games?
Maybe it's that you play too much and you become stupid.
Possible dangers are a lot of video games are violent, and if you grow up kind of with this violent sense, it can sometimes give you an idea that it might be okay.
You're a couch potato, you sit there too long.
It's violence and just becoming stupid.
Some possible benefits for playing video games.
Video games do give you really good hand-eye coordination, and you can kind of take from experiences in some video games. Maybe they're not as realistic if you're trying to learn how to shoot up people in GTA, don't learn from that, but sometimes they can deal with serious issues we have today in our world.
Well, it promotes creativity.
It's relaxing, not having a lot of stress.
Thumb coordination.
I think you're missing out on for playing video games.
Well, when I'm playing video games, I could be talking to other people or doing homework.
Exercise.
I play during the night, so not really missing much.
Probably missing out on a lot of social interactions, but what can I say? I like romancing elves more than talking to people.
Video games are fun and addicting, but as with anything that captures so much of our attention, moderation is usually the best policy. Electronics will be around forever, but these times in our lives will pass quicker than any of us may realize, so let's make the most out of it.
I don't know about you, Jake, but I miss the sunshine.
Yeah, I don't think we've seen it for the past 7 days or so, and we're not supposed to see it for another two more. During the long, dark winters here in New England, many of us suffer from cabin fever. We feel like we're climbing the walls, we're so restless.
That must be what these next guys were feeling.
Well, that's it for this episode.
Keep your head up, Triton. There's only 5 more school days until Christmas break.
I can't wait.
Happy weekend, everyone.